Hi everyone, welcome to fitness. Today's video is about strength training exercises and flexibility. Now, there's a few things to remember before we get started. One, make sure you have water. The other thing is, although I might be doing like sets of 10, if you can't do all 10, that's okay. Make sure that you know your limit. Do the best you can, take breaks when you need to, and keep pushing yourself. We're going to get started. We're getting started with a warm-up, and then you're going to see we're going to do arms and shoulders, some ab work, and then some leg work, and then we'll get into flexibility. We're going to start off with jumping jacks. So we're going to begin and I'll let you know when to stop. Ready? Begin. And more. Walk it out. You're going to single leg jump from side to side. Go. Go to the bathroom.
the arms. Watch your place. Give a few more things to open up before you get started. We're going to bring up the cardio level a little bit. We're going to hop side to side. Both feet this time. Ready? Begin.
Forward so you can see the ground better.
Alright, so for a regular push-up, arms are going to be straight. You want your back, everything to be as straight as possible. You don't want to curve it up. You don't. If you're sagging down a little bit, you're going to go with the second move that I showed you. So a regular push-up, this is the position. Again, if this is too hard for you, you're going to do a knee push-up. To get into the proper position for a knee push-up, again, you're on your knees. You're going to walk it out until, again, this part is all straight. That way you get the same type of exercise you would get from a regular push-up. We're going to do one set of 10. Then I'm going to have you go back into child's pose. So that's sitting back on your heels. Arms are going to be in front of you. It'll stretch out the shoulders. And then we're going to do another set of 10. Same thing, child's pose. After that, we're going to do a 20-second plank. And then we're going to shake out our arms, and then we're going to do a plank walk. So you want to count 4 on one side, 4 on the other. We're going to do that twice. Shake it out, and then do it again 2 more times. What that looks like, push-up position, high plank, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the other way. Again, do the best you can. If you have to take breaks, that's okay. Start with your push-up, get in position. Begin. I'm different. So again, if you want to do the regular push-ups, that's fine. If you want to do the knee ones, that's good too. Here we go. Get ready. Begin. I'm so good for you. Ready for a 20-second plank. If you can hold it, that's great. Don't be too hard on yourself, though. Remember, this is new. We're beginners. So whatever you need to do, it's fine. Just try your best. I'm doing my plank on the forearm, so you can do that, or you can do a high plank, like a push-up position, or you can come down here. Here we go. Get in position. Go. Get into our ab part. So before we get fully started, I want to go over position. So we're going to start with regular crunches. Be careful not to strain your neck. So if your hands are behind your head, you're not pulling on your neck. They can also be across your chest like this. Whatever makes you comfortable. Again, nothing should hurt, so do what you can. You should feel a bit of a burn, which is normal, but if anything hurts or your neck starts straining, take it easy. Do what you can. So you're going to start with sit-ups or crunches, which is regularly like that. We're going to do 10 of those, 10 double leg drops, then 10 bicycle crunches. So that's going to be elbow to opposite knee. Like that. After we do those three things, you're going to do starfishes, legs out, arms out, opposite hand to leg. After that, you're going to do single leg drops. Both legs come together, both come up, drop one at a time. So we're going to do all of those. We're going to do sets of 10. Shake it out. Repeat the same thing. At the end of that, I'm going to challenge you just a tiny bit. Make sure to remember to breathe. Get yourself ready. Ready? Go! Seven. Right now, bicycle crunches. Get those knees up. Two. Four. Eight. There we go. That was a fast 10. Starfish crunches. So legs out, arms out. That's one. That's two. That's three. Five more. We're almost there. Starfishes. Here we go.
Dearly beloved, if this love only exists in my dreams, don't make me.
Two more, you got this. Last one. We have double leg drops left. I mean single leg drops. Here we go, push through that tiredness. Bulk up, one drop at a time. Take a second again, get some water before we do our challenge. All right. I'm asking for five of these, so I'm going to go over an easier way and then the harder way. It's called a via. Regular, arms overhead. You're going to bring both arms and legs up and back down. Your harder version is going to be pushing up. So you bring your legs up, push. I'm going to stick with the basic version, but do whichever one you think is going to challenge you the most. Ready? Begin. Just give me five. One, two, three, four, and five. Whew. We're getting there. We have legs and a little bit of flexibility, and then we're done. Just fixing my camera so that you guys can see me standing. Now with a regular squat, it's important to know it's like sitting in a chair or on a couch. You want to make sure that your hips, they're a hinge, you're bending them. Put a little bend in your knee, so like you're pretending to sit on the couch, just like that. Make sure your form is okay. If your form is good and you're doing them slow, you're going to get more of a workout than if you do them fast with a bad form. Here we go. We're just doing 10. So we're going to do 10 squats, 10 lunges both sides, side lunges, 10 each, calf raises, 10. And then we're going to repeat it. Here we go. Ready? Begin. Yourself balance. You're gonna go down, back up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 5 more. Last one. Shake it out. Switch legs. Shake it out. Side lunges. You're doing 10, but 1 and 1, that counts as only 1. Here we go. 1. 2. 3. 4. 5. 7. Switch. Seven, phrases. Ready? Go. Seven, eight, nine, and ten. We're going to do one little challenge. Get a sip of water. Then we get into flexibility. We're going to try a few of these. We're going to try two on each side, but let me show you first. We're going to do front lunge, side lunge, back lunge, jump, and then switch sides. Front, side, back, jump. It's going to look like this. We're going to come forward, side, back, and jump. Other side, forward, side, back, and jump. Ready? Two on each side. So you're going to go one, 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 one. Then we're done. Here we go. Ready? Begin. Ready, front, side, back, last one. Good job. All right, so we're going to do a little bit of flexibility. Let me turn this down a little. This is going to help with future exercises. So let me just fix the camera. We're going to go back to the ground. You're going to start with your legs together, pointing and flexing your toes. Point, flex. Point, flex. Point, flex. Last one. Now you're going to reach for your toes. Now again, this shouldn't hurt. You should feel a stretch. It should be tight, but it shouldn't hurt. So if you can't reach your toes, say if you can only reach here, that's okay. Just next time you try a little bit further. Go until you feel a stretch. And then hold. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Release. We're going to do that one more time. Walk it back out. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. All right, so I'm going to come and face the camera. We're going to try. You can make a V if you are more flexible than Miss Farrell. Go right into a split. You want to go until you feel a stretch. When you get that stretch, I want you to hold it. Make sure that you're breathing. Point those toes. Make sure your back is straight too. Sit up nice and tall. Five, four, three, two, one. Sit back, relax a little. This time, we're going to walk our hands down. Again, don't make it hurt. Go until you feel the stretch, but don't hurt yourself. If something hurts, walk it back a little. Here we go. Walk. When you feel the stretch, you're going to hold and breathe into it. Breathe in your nose, out of your mouth. Your legs may be shaking, mine are. That's okay, that's normal. That's your body getting better. It's trying to get used to, and it's stretching those tight muscles that we just worked. So that's a good thing. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Walk it back. We're going to do one more of those. Walk it back out. See if you can go a little further this time. Cool down song on. I just want to tell you the difference. Okay? There's a difference between our stretching for flexibility and the cool down. So the flexibility stretching, again, is going to increase your range of motion with your legs, with the movement that we have in all sorts of fitness classes. The cool down is a stretch as well, but you're stretching all the muscles that you just worked. So it's really focusing on every muscle we worked, whether it's the wrist, the bicep, the tricep, you know, your quads, your hamstrings, your calves, stuff like that. So they're both really important. We're going to get started on that. You guys did amazing today. Okay? No one is in a competition with somebody else. You're in a competition with yourself. So just try to beat your personal record. Whatever you did this time, our next strength video, just try to beat what you did last time. That's all you can ever ask for. But good job. I'm going to put on our cool down song. Let's stretch. All right, nice deep breath in your nose and then exhale out of your mouth. Exhale. One more. Hold it up here. Exhale. All right, now with both of your hands, you're going to reach like you're climbing. roll out your wrists. Come back midway, right where I am. Cross one arm over. This is stretching your bicep, and it is, you should feel stretching your tricep a little bit as well. Take that elbow, put it behind your head. That gives you more of a tricep stretch.
Whenever you scold me, whenever you find me.
Other arm.
They told me I'm meant to be faithful and honor my people. And finally,
grab that elbow behind your head. Bring them both down. You're going to lean over to one side. Keep a bend in your knee. Other side. Take your wrist. Take your other hand. Gently press on those fingers. This is from all the planks and push-ups we did. Over your hand, same type of exercise. Switch. Flip over. Alright. We're going to go straight down. Flat back. Feel that stretch in the back of your legs. Walk it over to one side. Other side. Stretching out the quads. All right, now push your leg into your hand. So it's going to look like that. Release, switch sides. I'm going to come over here. And release. One more hamstring stretch. We're going to cross over. One crosses over the other. Come all the way down.
In my troubles and my tribulations.
Back up. Switch sides.
In my violence. In my turbulence.
Back up. Just roll out the neck.
In my anguish. In my pain.
Switch sides.
In my sorrow. In the promise of another tomorrow.
Roll your shoulders.
I'll never let you part.
Forward. One more deep breath in. Exhale. Great job, everybody.
See you next time.